It's phase 3.5 of the video feedback device. Phase 3 was the addition of the second monitor structure, and phase 3.5 is the addition of the third Roland switcher and this rotating Panasonic monitor here with the third camera here. I got the 3 foot pedals that trigger all three switchers and the finger switches that do the same. Changes the inputs on the switchers. And then the control knobs, hue, brightness, contrast, saturation for all 5 monitors. And this is going to be kind of a brief ontogenetic overview that is kind of showing the device through its evolution from the beginning to now. In the beginning, there was just the one monitor structure and the Nikon camera. And the upper monitor here can slide up and down, and the lower monitor can slide back and forth. There's a sheet of teleprompter glass between the two, so the output of the Nikon goes to both monitors, and the lower monitor is seen in the reflection of the glass, and the upper monitor is seen through the glass. The combination of those two images makes a fractal. And the camera can be rotated and moved back and forth. Phase 2 was the introduction of a second input and the Roland switcher to switch between that second input and the output of the Nikon. And that could either be on the lower monitor or upper monitor to different effect, selected on the control module here. So the reflection of that second input in the glass affects the fractal. And then there was the introduction of the rotating monitor with that second input to give some motion to that second input. And here in phase 3, the monitor doesn't rotate, but the camera does to almost exactly the same effect. And here I have the lower monitor turned all the way down to simulate phase 2. So, created things like this. And you could switch quickly between the second input and the Nikon. So that goes into feedback. That second input fractal goes into feedback. Then there was introduction of the feedback loop on the rotating monitor so that when you switched that, it would go into feedback. And since it was now possible to have video feedback as the second input, you could have fractals made of video feedback. And so here I have 2 dots on blue screen being keyed with the second Roland switcher over this second feedback loop. So that creates a feedback pattern that shows up on the bottom monitor here, affecting the fractal being made. Now in phase three, things start getting really interesting. I've turned up the brightness on the lower monitor on the second monitor structure. So now those same two dots on blue screen, keyed over the feedback, look like this. They affect the main fractal, switching between that and the Nikon output. Now with the third switcher in phase 3.5, I can make it so not only does the output of the second monitor structure affect what's going on the first monitor structure, but the output of the first affects what's going on the second at the same time, making a loop between the two and creating just a bit of insanity. So I've switched out the phone as the second input for the little Canon and this new rotating Panasonic monitor that gets its input from this Canon. And this creates its own feedback loop that can be switched between the other Canon loop, feedback, into feedback, into feedback. Check this out. Got a fractal here on the left made of the fractal here on the right. I added the second rotating monitor and the phone is looking at that monitor, and the output of that monitor is from the Canon looking at this rotating monitor, and the feedback from this phone looking at that monitor is luma keyed through the switcher over the monitor's feedback from this feedback loop here. Does that make sense? I can't even understand it. Of course, you got the Nikon here looking at the upper and lower monitors through the teleprompter glass. And this is the output of that new feedback loop with that fractal. Fractals made of fractals. Second rotating monitor. Yikes. Thank you. There you have it. Phase 3.5.